Hi everyone. So in this video we are going to talk about merge or overlap intervals, how to find out the availability time. Consider that you are sitting in your office and you have multiple colleagues, they have their own schedule, and your manager wanted to find out when to put a meeting. That can be another problem statement, or there can be another thing like these are the different meeting schedule of a different candidate in your team, right? So we need to find out what is the availability time where manager can put a meeting, or what are the intervals in which you can't set up a meeting. So like 1 to 3 employee 1 is busy, 2 to 6 employee 2 is busy, 8 to 10 employee 3 is busy, right? So in this case, finally the merge intervals, right? What will be the merge interval? 1 to 6, 8 to 10, 15 to 18, right? Means 1 to 6 you can't set up a meeting, but now you got an interval of 6 to 8, 10 to 15 where you can put. So here we will do const merge intervals. Here we just need to merge it and need to give the final interval to the manager. Okay, so we just need to do some checks. Okay, the input is not null, basic checks. Why these checks are necessary when you do a hacker rank test and all, these are the primary condition, because they will run your code against a test, against a variable number of inputs. That can be a null, that can be a zero, anything, right? So you should always check for these primary conditions. If your array is null or array length is less than 2, means so there is only one interval, then just return it directly, and then we will do the sorting of this array so that we can get things in order. If things are written in scattered way, because all the intervals should be in the ascending order. So here we will say A0 minus B0. So here we'll get a sorted elements. Now this is the input, right? And same way we will just return the output in a one single array. So this is a single output. We can use the reduce, there we can do the accumulation. Array dot reduce. Here we have two things, accumulator and the current element, and we are initializing the whole thing with the empty array, right? So here okay, let's start. So this with this interval, so we need actually two intervals to compare with one another. Consider this is an array we have received, and this is already sorted by ascending order. Now what we need to get is the last interval. Initially the last interval will be 0. If I just try to do accumulator.pop, okay, if we got a last interval, then we'll do this. Else, because we are just starting, so we will just push things in the accumulator. Accumulator.push the current value, and once we are done, as always, what we will do is we will return the accumulator so we can actually go to the next iteration. Okay, so if last, so first iteration, last will be undefined because there is nothing in the accumulator currently. We will just push the current index, current which is 13. Now while it is running for the second iteration, we will get the last, which will be 1 and 3. So the last in this case will be 1, 3. Now here we will check. So we got the last and we got the current. So current is 2, 6. Now here is the focus point is, it's very simple. Here we will just check last of 1. If that is greater than current of 0, that means last of 1 is 3 and current of 0 is 2. If 3 is greater than 2, that means we can merge these, right? If this is the case, then let new last will become last of 0, the first element of 0, and the second element of the current, which is current of 1. This is we got as a new, and we'll just push this to accumulator. Accumulator dot push new last. Okay, simple. So this is how we can actually merge the intervals which are overlapping. These are overlapping intervals that will get merged, and we will get the new interval which is 1, 6. Okay, so the same kind of things can happen with the when you are traveling. You have flights, there are number of arrivals, number of departures. Whenever you are arriving, you can actually increment, and when you are departure, you can actually decrement a counter, and then you can decide, okay, what was your original station from where you start your travel, and what was your last station from where you are to which place you are arriving, something like that. Okay, I think this is fine. So let's talk about some more questions, like getting the permutations of a string, rotating a string and finding out if it is a substring or not. A few more questions, and then we will talk about some asynchronous JavaScript things using ES6 features, async await and all.